and Brad, the two most famous physical therapists on the internet.
Hi, folks. I'm Bob Schrupp, physical therapist.
Brad Heineck, physical therapist.
Here we are, the most famous physical therapist on the internet.
In our opinion, of course, Bob.
Stop strengthening hamstrings. Do this instead. Now, this is, you know, we evolve as we go along. We try to, you know, always learn, Brad.
Right.
You know, we've done some videos on strengthening hamstrings, and there are people that should be strengthening their hamstrings.
Sure.
But there's a lot that should not, because the hamstrings are strong enough, and we'll get into that. By the way, if you're new to our channel, please take a second to subscribe to us. We provide videos on stay healthy, fit, pain-free, and we upload every day. We're not giving away anything right now, Mike? Okay. We're going to be giving away something tomorrow. Go to bobandbrad.com. If you're watching this on a Saturday, go there the next day on Sunday and go to our website. Go to the giveaway section. We're giving away something. It'll be really cool. Or you can find it on Facebook, Bob and Brad. If you want a short version of us, go to Twitter or Instagram. We got a 60-second version of our program every day. All right, because we as a nation, as a people, sit a lot, and because we develop poor back movements, a lot of times what happens, our glutes are not firing like they should. Our gluteus maximus, our minimus, our medius.
Those butt muscles.
Yeah. And when they aren't firing, you get what is called gluteal amnesia.
Mm-hmm.
It's also called pelvic cross syndrome. It's also called lower cross syndrome. It's also called dead butt syndrome. But basically, the butt muscles aren't firing like they should be. And that's your biggest muscle on your lower extremities. And you should be relying on that when you're lifting things and doing functional activities.
For sure.
And if you're not, what happens is, I'm going to give this example here. Let's say I'm going to bend wrong. I'm sorry, Mike. I probably threw you off here getting so tall. Let's say instead of lifting correctly, if I lift correct here, you can see the butt muscles are going to be working. If I'm lifting incorrectly here, now the back is firing up more, and I'm also relying on more of my hamstrings. They're firing off. So
sure.
What happens over time, you develop this pattern. These muscles actually get to be fairly strong, but they're also putting the back under stress.
Sure.
And the hamstrings become very strong, and they become overactive.
So you're saying by firing, they've done EMG studies to figure out which muscles are actually contracting and which ones are not, and to the degree they're tracting, is it a partial contraction, or are they working
well
hard?
Even how the sequencing.
Okay,
so like you can actually do this, Brad. I'm doing this spontaneously, Brad, and I didn't plan this, but you can actually lay down and you can feel your butt and your hamstring at the same time.
Sure.
And lift up your leg. And you want the butt to fire in first before the hamstring.
Sure.
On some people, the hamstring is going to fire first. And it was on me.
Yep.
And I've changed it now so that my butt muscle fires.
Right.
I'm trying to keep this simple. I want to, basically, we're going to show you the exercises you should do.
Mm-hmm.
I guess you're going to have to trust us that it's important that
you're
going to strengthen these muscles here. You can read more about it, but when the hamstrings are over-firing, it causes all sorts of problems. It can actually cause hip pain because the way that they are situated on your femur.
Changes the mechanics of the joint.
Changes the mechanic of the joint, yep. And it can cause that sit bone pain.
Yep.
You know, because the hamstrings are getting too much stress on them.
Sure,
so,
sure.
All right, the first one we're going to do, I want you to actually stretch your hip flexors, because if they're tight, they can actually inhibit the glutes maximus
sure.
for firing. So, simple way to do that, you're going to go ahead and throw a pillow on the ground. Which way should I go, Brad? Probably this way?
Yeah, I would do the
like that.
Left leg, yep.
Yep. Yep. So, you're going to have really good posture here.
Yep.
And I'm going to lean forward. You know, the key to this is not just leaning forward like this. I'm leaning the hip forward too, extending the hip.
Right. So you can see the angle of the femur here relative to the angle of the torso, which is vertical. And he's getting that stretch right where that pocket is.
Right.
And that's where that hip flexor is.
The
nice
hip flexors,
three
major muscles there that can really shorten up when you do a lot of sitting.
Yep.
So in addition to, you know, the butt getting the pressure,
mm-hmm.
it's also tightening up muscles that are inhibiting it. So obviously you would want to do both sides.
Right. So you're going to hold that for
30 seconds to a minute, whatever you have time for. So, all right, next one. We're going to go ahead and do some glute squeezes. I'm going to go ahead and start off just kind of for a beginner. You're just going to lay prone on your stomach, and I'm going to bend the leg. And I'm just going to lift it up like this. And before you do that, even squeeze your butt together like you're putting a quarter between the cheeks and you're going to hold it there.
Butt squeezers. Like that. Yep. So he's flexing the knee like this because that helps take the hamstring out of the contraction.
Equation, right.
It helps emphasize the glutes.
Yep. Now the glutes are doing most of the work. Again, if Brad, I were to tell you to strengthen one muscle in the body,
yep,
it probably would be your glutes because they are so important in all the functional activities. Take pressure off your back. And so this is a great one to do for nearly everyone. I'm sure there's exceptions, but I can't think of too many. So
well, you figure you're walking. Everyone yep. walks, or most yep. everyone.
Everybody walks. Everybody's bending forward and picking
right.
stuff up.
Very functional movements.
This is a more advanced one, Brad. So again, you'd be squeezing the butt together, but you'd be lifting up towards the sky like this.
So you're also working, contracting your core muscles, right? So
yep.
you've got good stabilization of your core and the pelvis.
Am I going straight up? I can't tell.
You're doing pretty good, Bob. Yep.
Okay.
So you're going to just go up and down 10 times
yeah,
like this?
Yeah, I'd probably do a 5, 6, 7 second hold or so. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It count fast and it ends up being about 5 seconds.
Right.
So, all right. Another one. We're going to go ahead and let's do bridging, Brad. So this is a different way to go at it. Really the same issue. We're going to go ahead and lift up like this. And the same thing, you want to squeeze your butt together before you lift.
Sure. Yep.
And when you get a little more advanced, you're going to go ahead and go with one leg.
Yeah.
And this is one of those signs, if your hamstrings are a little bit overactive, they start cramping on you easier.
Yes, right.
And mine used to cramp on me fairly quickly, and yep. now I can tell my butt muscles are taking over. And
I like that.
They're not cramping as easy.
And
so
I do exercises like this, and one thing I found that I don't use a pillow. I just let my head rest on the floor or get a pad down because otherwise you can develop neck pain.
Right.
I mean, it's got nothing to do with your butt. Yeah, we don't want to develop a neck problem because you're looking up.
It's funny because I've been doing some core workout and I've been doing, the lifting the shoulders up. And,
sure.
and my neck, too, originally gave me problems with that.
Yeah.
So you got to really watch it. All right. We're also going to go ahead and do we want to get the gluteus medius and minimus, the side
sure.
muscles here. So we're going to go ahead and I'm going to do some clamshells. So you're on the sideline position here, and you're just going to go up like this. Now, these are small muscles, and I'm speaking from experience here because I started working these, and I started off with a black band. I'm like, I'm a strong guy. I can go ahead and one of those loop bands, Brad's going to show it. And I was doing it every day. I got so sore, I literally had to stop because doing it for like a week because I got those muscles. I think I even had minor tears in them. So that you want to start off with just without weight.
Right.
Doing it. That'll be enough. These are small muscles. And then eventually you can add the band in.
So you're doing 10 to 15 reps typically? Yep.
Mm-hmm. So I'm going to show this figure 4-1, Brad, too, because this is interesting to me. This is a very difficult one for me to do. So I'm going to lay flat, and then I'm going to go ahead and cross my left ankle over my right knee.
Can you see that, Mike? Is that pretty clear?
All right.
On top of that.
Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to lift up my knee, and it's really hard for me to do.
So, yeah, right here, he's lifting straight up. There isn't much space there. There isn't a big movement, but there's a lot of
a lot of work going on.
A lot of glute. You feel in that glute?
Oh, back? God, yeah.
Feels good.
Oh. So
I have a feeling someone, 20 years younger might be a little
yeah,
more
exactly.
Pliable.
They're going to go, what's wrong with this old man? But but if you're near in the sixth decade of your life, give this a try once, and you're going to find out. Well, I'm curious, Brad. You go ahead and try it.
I haven't done this one yet.
I'm serious. I want to see how he does.
Let me take my glasses off, Bob.
You better not make it look easy. Oh, look at this.
Bob, you got to remember how I walk.
Yeah, that's right.
My feet are out like a
duck.
That's
right. Brad is externally rotates.
I definitely feel that right in there.
Yeah, don't lift up too much now. Stay down. There you go. You're better on the other side.
Yeah, I can feel that. My left side.
I think it's a function of also how much motion you have in your hip.
Yeah.
But I can feel that. I mean, I can feel it after the fact of doing it now that, the muscles have been working. My external rotators are really weak on my hips. So
Yeah, so this will let you know, give you some information on your hip.
But I after I've been doing this, my running's gotten easier and my squats have gotten easier. We were just talking about this beforehand. Yeah. And it really, you know, and again, it's going to help you functionally as you go through life, and less likely to hurt your back, less likely to hurt your hamstrings.
Yeah.
So
I'm still.
You're still trying to.
I'm digesting all this. Sure. You know, it's a new concept. I haven't read that part of the book yet.
There's been a lot on this. I've been, you know, once you see something and then you see a lot of it, you know, like it keeps hitting you in the head.
Right.
And you're like, oh, okay, I got it. It is something.
Sure.
You know, so at first I was like, gluteal amnesia, but so. All right. Remember, Brad and I can fix this about anything.
Except for
a broken heart.
There you go.
But we're working on it.
Glutes and the heart.
There we go.